Cecil Rodney.
An honor, sir.
Sir. George Reed. And Colonel Thomas McKeon.
Dr. Hall.
Your servant.
I wonder if I might speak to you for a moment in private.
I trust, Caesar, when you're through converting the poor fellow to independency, that you'll give the opposition a fair crack at him.
You're too late, John. Once I get them, they're got. Dr. Lyman Hall of Georgia, Mr. John Dickinson of Pennsylvania.
An honor, sir.
Your servant, sir.
Tell me, Doctor, where do you stand on the question of...
Independence?
Treason.
I've no stomach for it.
Ah, then be careful not to dine with John Adams. Between the fish and the souffle, you'll find yourself hanging from an English rope. Your servant, sir.
Oh, Judge Wilson, forgive me. But how can anyone see you if you insist on standing in Mr. Dickinson's shadow? James Wilson, also of Pennsylvania.
Sir. An honor, sir.
Morning. Good morning, ladies.
Good morning.
Steady.
There we are.
Make gangway, sir. Make gangway.
Good morning, Mr. Wilson. Good morning. Watch where you're going.
Damn it, over there.
Hello.
McNair, get me out of this thing. Watch out for the foot. Good morning, all.
Morning, man. Good morning.
Here you are, two coppers apiece. Now straight back to jail with you. Good morning, Stephen.
Morning, Benjamin.
Good morning.
Here we go. What are you staring at? Haven't you ever seen a great man before?
Good Lord, sir. Do you have the honor to be Dr. Franklin?
Yes, I have that honor. Unfortunately, the gout accompanies the honor.
Ah, been living to I again, eh, Peppy?
Oh, Stephen, I only wish King George felt like my big toe all over.
McNair! Fetch a pillar! And two more arms!
Well, Franklin, where's that idiot Lee? Is he back yet? I don't see him.
Softly, John. Your voice is hurting my foot.
One more day, Franklin. Then I shall do the proposing.
Gentlemen, the usual morning festivities concluded. I will now call Congress to order. Mr. Thompson.
Second Continental Congress meeting in the city of Philadelphia is now in session. 7 June 1776, the 380th meeting.
Sweet Jesus.
The Honorable John Hancock of Massachusetts Bay, President.
Thank you, Mr. Thompson. Mr. McNair, the stores of rum and other drinking spirits are hereby closed to the colony of Rhode Island for a period of 3 days.
Yes, sir. Johnny, you can't do that.
Sit down, Mr. Hopkins. You've abused the privilege. The chair would like to take this opportunity to welcome Dr. Lyman Hall of Georgia to this Congress and hopes he will make the best of it. My God, it's hot. The secretary will read the roll.
All members present with following exceptions. Mr. Payne, Mr. Jerry, Mr. Samuel Adams of Massachusetts, Mr. Morton of Pennsylvania, Mr. Wythe and Mr. Richard Henry Lee of Virginia, and the entire delegation of New Jersey.
I'm concerned over the continual absence of 1/13th of this Congress. Where is New Jersey?
Somewhere between New York and Pennsylvania.
Thank you very much. Dr. Franklin, have you heard anything? Your son resides there.
Son, sir? What son?
The Royal Governor of New Jersey, sir.
As that title might suggest, sir, we are not in touch at the present time.
Yes. Well, now for the weather report. Mr. Jefferson of Virginia. Mr. Jefferson!
Oh, present, sir.
May we hear about the weather? As if it weren't speaking for itself.
87 degrees of temperature, 30.06 inches of mercury, wind from the southwest for the rest of the day, and tonight I'm leaving for home.
On business?
Family business.
Give her a flourish for me, young fella.
Oh!